Right now, we are the happiest group, the people of the world. It's incredible what we have done. It was a final for us, not for them. Right after in the locker room, we thought it was over. It's the ideal, it's the perfect place to work. Hello, 1, 2, 3, 4. Good?
Good.
Perfect.
We've won all 4 English trophies in 1 season, no one's ever done it. Where does this rank for you in terms of your own personal achievements?
One of the best, especially in which place we did it. So England is the toughest one. So the people before I came here, so England Premier League on the English football is the more difficult one. So, and I said, why? When you are here, you realize, especially for the incredible calendar, for the tough calendar, for the quality of the opponents, the physicality, the weather conditions. We were in 4 or 5 months when the weather conditions are terrible. So it's so demanding and do it, you know. But I cannot deny how happy I was in Munich and the good things we have done. And especially at home, when I was born, when I grew up, where my club of my heart, the club of my heart, so is FC Barcelona, so do it what we have done always was incredible.
To win back-to-back titles, no team's done that for 10 years. I mean, that is proof really, isn't it, that English football is so difficult. And this year, with Liverpool being so good, is the title win this year even sweeter than and even better than last year, maybe? Because we've been pushed this time by a really great challenger.
I think the first one is one of the nicest ones. So it was my first league, for example, in Barcelona was, I remember, the nicest one. I think the last season was the nicest one. But of course, we could not expect in the beginning of the season would be the same. So the contenders will be better, and especially Liverpool was there. So, and of course, we won this back-to-back against the best rival as possible. So it was incredible what they have done, and was a little bit more incredible what we have done, maintaining his pace and his level during the season. We cannot forget we were 7 points behind for a long time. And in that moment, you can have the tendency that you drop or you give up. And that didn't happen. And that's the reason why we won the 4 titles. When you won the 4 titles, because we were consistent in any departments and in all the departments in the backroom staff, and everybody make his own contributions. Because win one title for 6-7 games with the, normally the cups, it happened in Carabao or FA Cup, even the Champions League, you have to win 6, 7, 8 games, the title is over. But the Premier League, and especially win all of them, you have to be more consistent and incredible focus every single day.
198 points over 2 seasons. How do you feel that this team and you and all your staff have managed to get a squad of players that are so consistent every single time that we play football?
Well, 198 points speaks for itself. You cannot do it if you are not consistent every week, every 3 days. And I think that is the most difficult thing in a sport, to be consistent for a long time. And today, 2 seasons is not an eternity, but it's a long time.
In the summer, we sent 16 players to the World Cup, which was more than any other team. And then when we came back for the Community Shield and Arsenal away, I remember expecting to see a team that was tired, but we actually saw a team that looked fresh and hungry. How important was it to come straight back in and hit that level again?
Well, that is a good lesson to understand the physical preparation condition is not the most important thing in football. So we start to play Community Shield in the first leagues with a lack of training sessions. So we train in few. We learn from that there are other aspects in football that are, I think, more important than the physical condition. So I think run to run and make exercises for nothing is waste of time. We have Lorenzo Benaventuras in the Sam Erith group, like they are a masters, they are a genius, they are an incredible, especially Lorenzo is an incredible person. So we were together from the first year in Barcelona, and it would have been impossible to do what I have done without him. It's impossible. I cannot imagine my career without his advices, his knowledge about the teams, about the amount of the training session, the intensity, the high and low and medium, and how you handle, you know, the injuries to avoid it. So he's an incredible talent guy, and of course he helped us to be consistent in these 3 seasons.
One of my favourite games of the season was when we beat Manchester United at home and we scored. The 3rd goal was a 44 pass move. Do you think that goal perhaps gets to the essence of the way you like to play football, that keeping possession and almost toying with the opposition, if you like?
Yeah, it's one of the reasons why, but not the only, because sometimes it happened when the game was a little bit broken, a little bit more spaces, but you cannot win only with this aspect. So when sometimes the teams can open, you have Kevin on the pitch and Raj in the pitch and Sterling, Raj and Leroy and the other ones, you can use incredible counter-attacks, you know that. But the essence, one of the essences is to be active. Don't wait what they do, the opponents, you know. We decide what we want to do in our game. That is the main thing. And to do that, you have to have the ball. So you have to play with the ball. That, I think, is one of the keys of our game. So all our training sessions with the ball, all we want to do is play and play and play and play. And after that, when we talk about defensive, is we have to regain the ball. And what we want to do is that. That is the big fundamental, so that the big part of our idea. Just try to play with the ball and run like an animal, everybody, to regain the ball and play again and play again and play again. Sometimes you can give a lot of passes, sometimes because the opponent make it uncomfortable. Or they press, for example, when you have a team like press so high and so intense, it's impossible, because once you make two or three passes, you have to attack quick. When a team defend low block and just wait, you have more chances to make a lot of passes. It depends on that. But the essence is that, is play. Always I believe the players want to play with the ball. I have to respect their desire, their wishes, and always we try to do it.
We had a bit of a difficult period in December. As a manager in a situation like that, when results are dipping slightly, how do you then pick your players back up and get them back?
I would say in the same way, like we win. So when we win, we'll reanalyze or we recheck more than when we lose. Try to discover when we win, the reason why we win and the bad things that still we can do, the bad things we do. And when we lose, try to discover the reason why. Sometimes it's emotional, sometimes it's we are tired for the amount of games, sometimes it's a lack of rhythm or the opponent is better. We don't have too much time to be happy when you win or be depressed when you lose. In around the corner in 2-3 days you have another game, and that is what you have to do to prepare the next one.
The Liverpool game at home as well was a bit of a crucial turning point. Amazing performance from the players that night, but also from the fans. Does that night stand out to you in terms of atmosphere and feeling like everybody was coming together?
Yeah, especially the atmosphere. Yeah, sure, definitely. It was a nice game. It was a final for us, not for them. When we lose that game, it's over. When we draw, maybe still alive, but we're difficult. Came back 4 points, okay, a lot of games to play. A lot of things could happen. We didn't play good, especially with the opponent. It's incredibly tough. But we play with desire to say, still we want to be alive. Still we want to be in the title race to be champions, to make back-to-back. So that game showed me, like after defeat the champions against Tottenham, playing Tottenham again, it was not a good game. In the three games we played the Tottenham, the four games the Tottenham had the game more chances to score a goal. In that game, Eddie was incredible. So, but in the same times we show after incredible tough emotion, after being dropped from the Champions League, no, to lose there, how we react in terms of, okay, we don't play good, we don't play in the way we can play, but we show incredible spirit. And to win 4 prizes, you play a lot of these kind of games. Not everything is easy, not everything. That's why we win a lot of games and a lot of titles. There are different ways, you know, not just one. And these teams can do it.
You mentioned the Newcastle game before the defeat. Did you or anybody in your team think that maybe that night it was over?
Yeah, right after in the locker room, that would be impossible. We thought next day Liverpool play at home against Leicester and they have win incredible amount of huge of games and in right after it was almost over. So it's difficult to recover the games. But the fact that they didn't win, still we were there and we knew Liverpool should play at home. So still we were alive.
From that point on to win 14 games from then till the end of the season is incredible, particularly because the margin for error was so small. Any error and it was over. It's testament to your players, isn't it, that they managed to string 14 games back to back with the pressure being so high.
When we start to make these 14 games in a row, the last season when we make 18 games in a row winning, so we don't think about that. The fact that we play most of the games after Liverpool, and the fact that we know we cannot, you know, drop 2 points or make a draw or lose a game, sometimes it's easy to prepare a mental approach to the players. So I think everybody was convinced that the only chance to be until the end, chance to win the title is the Premier League is win every single game. Sometimes when the players go out there and said, okay, we draw, okay, we have chance. If we lose, we have chance. Sometimes more difficult to, you know, to play the way we play. We knew it, not just the manager, everybody knew it, so win or we are out. And sometimes helps to, you know, to play every game. And during the game we are losing 1-0, okay, and after that we have to attack. We have to, you know, move forward and do what we have to do, and sometimes helps.
One of the toughest games in that run was Leicester at home, and Vincent Kompany stepped up and scored, you know, one of the most amazing goals we've ever seen at the Etihad Stadium. Try and sum up for me what Vincent means to this football club, and also the impact he had during the final games of this season, because he's been absolutely superb again.
Well, the final, I think, the season, the spirit, so the goal is really incredible. I think he shoots with a desire to score a goal. Vincent, when he always fit, it was important. He took an important role in our team. Unfortunately, sometimes could not happen. But this club, you know, this club is what it is for long history for the old players, you know, Mike Summerby or, you know, Colin Bell and incredible people here. But since Sheikh Mansour took over this club and Khaldun was in charge, you know, leading this club, I'm pretty sure there are a few players that changed this club. I'm thinking with Pablo Zabaleta, Joe Hart, Vincent Kompany, David Silva, Sergio Aguero. They're incredible players, you know, that helps this club making a step forward. I think Vincent leading these kind of groups, and he deserves all my respect. So the club I found when I arrived, he helps to build it, and I think these 3 years together, we try being together with all the other people to maintain, you know, to maintain the club in the position that we want.
How do you replace somebody like Vincent Kompany off the field?
That would be difficult. It would be so difficult. Because everyone is everyone, but he believes all the time when he says what he thinks, and we will miss him. I will miss him a lot. Of course, I wish him all the best in the next step in his life. But his part is an incredible part of the history of this club, for sure.
What would it feel for you to be able to bring that European trophy back to the people here?
So I read, and we accept that challenge. So always football giving another opportunity. And the people say, until we don't win the Premier League, you cannot be considered one of the greatest or the best teams. It's okay, we accept the challenge. So I know this club years ago, one decade ago, no one could consider it to win the Premier League. And now the people start to talk about that. Though that is the first step, that's good. So we knew we'd accept the challenge. If it happened next season, will be next season. What happened next season will be next season. With me, without me, with this kind of group or without this group, that is important to be in there and fighting for that. And maybe one day it's happened. If it doesn't happen, so, okay, lucky. So we try it. The important is to be there all the time and try to do it, like the Premier League. So we won it or we could lose it. But important, until the end, we were there. And the people don't have regrets, and I'm pretty sure of that. So we could have not win the Premier League, the people would have been happy with us. Because all the people who won away in our games and home, they know who we are. We try it and we are honest and we respect our game, we try to score goals. And at the end, that is the nicest thing we can give for our people.
The margin, the so fine margins in that competition, how do you control those fine margins, and how do you try and find a way for us to make the next step in the Champions League next season or the season after?
We were to control as much as possible this margin, but we cannot control it. No manager in the world, no team in the world. There are situations that are unpredictable and control it. I won many prizes for that 1 inch, and we lose for 1 inch. So, and you are an incredible team for that, or you are a not good team for that. So right now we are the happiest group, the people of the world, in terms of it's incredible what we have done, but in the same times we are incredibly conscious that we, doing the same we could have lost, especially the Premier League. I won Champions League when I made one shot on target in the semi-final second leg in the 91st minute and win the final in one. And I lose semi-finals after shooting 32 shots on target with the same team, Chelsea. So that is what it is. That competition is what it is. You have to work to control as much as possible. You have to avoid to make individual mistakes or group of mistakes in this kind of games. But that's why it's football, unpredictable.
For you and for this football club, style of play is very important. How do you create a team? How do you do it? How do you get a team to play such open and attacking football all the time?
Well, we came here with this idea, you know, to try to convince the players a little bit to play in that way. I think one of the important things is the club followed this idea. They don't judge about the bad results if the idea is not good. So normally most of the clubs, if you win, that is perfect. If you don't win, that is not good. Here it doesn't happen. That is one of the reasons why we decide to come here. First the chairman, but the CEO, and especially the sports director who take the decisions about the new players that they won't want to play. We will not be judged. It depends on win or lose. But of course the statistics and the results must come. If not, we cannot continue. We live in one world when you have to take a result to go forward. Of course there are numbers and the goals conceded and many records that have been broken, but at the end football and all the sports is a little bit emotions, a bit what do you feel, and I think especially in our fans, they are happy for the way we play.
You mentioned the sporting director there, Cheeky. I was reading a book recently and there was a quote in there from him that said, when you win in the way that we win, it becomes addictive. Having possession of the ball, scoring goals, attacking teams. Is that how you feel, that it's just the best way to win football matches?
I don't know if it's the best way, because there are many ways that are good. It's the way we believe. You can play for 1,000,000,000 different times and you can win in all the times. It's impossible to win in the way you don't believe it. And we believe in that way from the day one until the last day, and we are going to continue in that way.
Do you think that the support that you have from Cheeky and the people at this football club, that perhaps you mentioned earlier, other football clubs don't necessarily have that, do you think that is the most important thing that has allowed you to do what you've done?
No, definitely. I think Cheeky is the most important person in my career as a manager. So now maybe it's easy to trust me. But when I was anyone, one in the managerial career, he trusted me. So without him, I would not be here. So always I will be in debt of him, grateful, because more than incredible sport director, he's so shy, so humble, he's never appeared in the media. Always I said, talk sometimes, so always I have to talk. So make me, give me a hand to talk and express your feelings or the way you want to play. No, that don't belong to me. He's an incredible person. He's an incredible human being, and nothing has happened in my career. It would have been without him. And of course, when we talk about football, we are in the same ideas, in the same base, and that's why it's easier.
When you and Cheeky go out and look for new signings, how do you work out that the player you are targeting is not just a good player, which is obvious from watching, but also a really good person?
Yeah, but it's not easy to find, to know it, because we can talk for other people, what the people believe. At the end, we'll say the key point, because live with the 10, 11 months when the guy's not sound good with the team or with all of us, that is not nice. But you never know, you know? You have to open the box. Until you don't open the box, you don't know it.
When a lot of people who've worked with you talk about you, they always use the word intense, that you're very intense in the way that you approach your job. Does that tire you out during the course of a season, especially a season like this where we played 61 games? Do you feel tired at the end of a season?
Yeah, all season are when finish are tired, but you are less tired when you arrive at the end and you know you fight for doing the titles. So, but also the managers, we need a little bit to work out, a little bit, you know, relax a little bit. Don't be with the player, especially when you are so, you know, be you know, pay attention is when you are with the players, and because they demand you a lot, they demand a lot of yourself. But we have time, you know, have time to disconnect it.
Johan Cruyff was obviously your biggest influence in football, and you had a great relationship. He was like a second father to you, but at first, when you were a young player, he was very hard on you. Do you think you're like that sometimes with your players, to try and get them to the position they should be? Somebody like Leroy, Raheem, players like young players like that?
So I don't know. I don't know what the players means, our behaviors or my behaviors to them. Only I'm pretty sure they know I do the best. We do the best for them, for the team. We work for them. They cannot deny it. For the players they play usually, they love me. The players they don't play, they don't love me. So that is the part of the situation of the game. I understand completely. But even the players, they are not satisfied to working with. They know we work a lot for them. That is no doubt about that.
Do you like living and working here in England? Do you feel that you're allowed to relax? You're not bothered by people, and you're allowed to just go about your business?
Yeah, I think it's no better place in the world to play in England, to play or do your job like as a manager here in England. I can compare it in Spain, in Germany. I have not been in other countries, but they would be quite similar. If I go to Italy, it would be quite similar like in Spain. It's no better place. You know, how the fans, you know, and other people's the fans boo you if you don't win or your play don't good. Here, it's always support you. It looks like you. I am a blue shirt. I am one of yours. So, and you go to the street, the people have to support you. I remember the first year was difficult. After defeat in Monaco, we were out for the Champions League, and the Premier was not good. And we were understanding that people support you, respect during the week. There's no media during the week, and you can work calm. And it's the ideal. It's the perfect place to work, especially, I don't know, in other clubs here. So I felt that in the first season when we were no win one title, how they support me. And this situation, I don't forget it. I don't forget it. Now it's easy to be close to me. It's easy to, you know, to say, oh, how good you are. And I know how it was that this job. So in that moment when it doesn't work so well like we could expect in the first year, because I need time and everybody needs time, so all of us we need time, how they support me. The chairman, the first of all, Khaldun, I cannot forget his messages after the defeats and the bad moments. And of course I cannot forget Chiki, Ferran and all backroom staff, how close we are. And sit with calm and decide what we need to improve, especially the team. And that's why I'm happy to reward, you know, their confidence they have to me with my players the next two seasons.
Pep, it's been an amazing season, and I think I speak for every Manchester City fan when I say thank you so much for all your work.
A pleasure, and the best is coming.